Hello students, today we are going to discuss topic number 21 from our grammar book. The name of this topic is prepositions. So students, in your earlier class, that is in standard second, you have already learned about prepositions. What are prepositions? Preposition means the words like in, on, under, above, over, below. All these words are called as prepositions. So first, I will tell you what is the definition for prepositions. So students, a word that shows the relation of one thing with another in a sentence is called a preposition. So in a sentence, we are having words. So prepositions are the words which tell us about the relation of one thing to the another thing in a particular sentence. The words like in, on, under, above, into, these words are called as prepositions. But what is the work of these prepositions? These prepositions, they tell us about the position of some object. Maybe the position of some animal, position of some bird, position of a person, or position of any object. So the words which tell us about the position of some or the other thing, they are called as the prepositions. They also show the relation between one thing and the other thing in the same sentence. So students, the other words, or we can say the other prepositions, are near, between, above, over, under, all these words which tell us about the position and which show the relation are called as prepositions. Now let us move on to your grammar book. In your grammar book, you have a picture, and below the picture there are few sentences which we need to understand so that we can easily understand what these prepositions are exactly about. So students, this is page number 62 of your grammar book. Here you can see a picture. Yes, we have a house here. In front of the house, we are having a tree, and this man is sitting under the tree. Here we can see a lake. A boy is swimming in this lake. Also, we can see a cow over here. So now, just see. What is it said? What do you see? So I have already told you what is seen in this picture. So we can see a boy is sitting under the tree. So where is the boy? He is under the tree. The position of this boy, or the place where he is sitting, is told. It is under the tree. So under is a preposition here. The next sentence says a cow is standing near the lake. So as I told you, here is the lake, and this cow is standing here near the lake. So what is the position? It is near the lake. The next is the house is behind the tree. So here we have a house, and in front of the house we have a tree. So the house is behind, at the back of the tree. The boy is swimming in the lake. So the boy who is swimming here, where is he? He is in the lake, inside the lake. The next is the bird is sitting on the roof of the house. So here you can see a little bird. Where is it? It is on the roof of the house. So students, these words like under, near, behind, in, on, all these words, they are telling us about the position of this boy, cow, house, bird, boy, tree. They are telling us about the position or the place where they are. And also they are showing the relation between the other things or other words in the sentence. So these are called as prepositions. So students, the word that shows the relation of one thing with another in a sentence is called preposition. Now here you can see few more sentences. Let us learn about some more prepositions. We go to school every day. We go to school. So this word to is giving us the relation between we and school. Similarly, I am standing with Sahil. So I am standing, but with whom? With is the word which is showing the relation between I and Sahil. We are waiting for the bus. V and bus. The relation between this V and bus is shown by the word for. We are standing in front of a tree. So, where is our position? In front of a tree. A bird is flying over the tree. So, what is the position of the bird? It is over the tree. Right? Similarly, here you can see page number 63 of your grammar book. Farah is standing between her father and mother. So, in this picture, we can see that this little girl, her name is Farah. And she is standing just in between her mother and her father. The man is standing by the window. So, here you can see a window. And he is standing near by the window. So, it is said by the window. The dress is made of silk. So, the relation between dress and silk is shown by the word of. So, the material which is used in making of the dress is silk. They are smiling at one another. So, here you can see all these three. They are looking at one another and they are giving a smile. June comes after May. So, the relation between June and May is shown by the word after. So, all these words like between, by, of, at, after, all these are prepositions. Now, let us solve the exercise. Here you can see, underline the prepositions in these sentences. The bird is flying over the tree. Right? So, now tell me, what is the position of the bird? It is flying. But where is it flying? Over the tree. So, the word over is showing the relation between the bird and the tree. So, over is a preposition. Jay sat between Ronnie and Sunny. So, what is the position of Jay? Jay is between. So, between is the preposition. The third sentence, please listen to me. So, the relation between please listen to me. This is a sentence. So, what is the relation between me and the other words? The word to is showing the relation between the other words of the sentence. The clock is on the wall. So, what is the position of the clock? The clock is on the wall. The dog is sleeping under the table. So, what is the position of the dog? It is under the table. Right? Similarly, you have to read these other sentences and you have to identify and underline the prepositions. The next we will see. Here you can see. Look at the pictures and choose the correct preposition from the brackets. The clock is dash the wall. On or between? Yes, it is on the wall. The clock is on the wall. The cat is sitting dash the kittens. Here you can see a cat. Where is it? Is it on the kittens or between the kittens? Yes, it is between the kittens. So, we will write between in the blank. The next is the boy is playing dash a bat. With a bat or in front of a bat? You can see here the boy is holding the bat in his hand. It means that he is playing with a bat. Right? Now let us move on to the next page, that is page number 64. So students, the pictures are given on the sides of the sentences. You can see the pictures and you can fill the blanks with the correct options. So, you have to do this on your own. The next is underline the prepositions in the paragraph. Here is a paragraph and here we can see the picture about which this paragraph is. So, this picture is described here in this paragraph. So, we have to find out which are the prepositions. Let us see. Jyoti is on the sea beach. So, where is Jyoti? What is her position? On the sea beach. So, on is the preposition. Jyoti is lying on a bench, on a beach chair under an umbrella. So, John is lying on a beach. So, on is a preposition. Also, under an umbrella. So, position is under an umbrella. A boat is sailing on the water. So, on is again a preposition. A small boy is sitting with his father and mother in the boat. A small boy is sitting with. So with is the preposition. Also further father and mother in the boat. So in is the position of the boy. A dog is sitting near John. So near is the position of the dog. Jyoti's father is looking at her. So at is a preposition. They are all enjoying themselves. So here we finish this paragraph. Next, page number 65. Here you can see, look at the picture and fill in the blanks with prepositions to complete the paragraph. So here are few prepositions given, and here you can see a picture. The picture is of a classroom, and below few sentences are written on this picture itself. So you can make use of these prepositions and fill the blanks over here. This you have to do on your own. It is a homework for you so that you can understand where to use what type of prepositions.